How do I, campers? How are we, Shona?
Morning.
This is what they look like after a night with Joshua. He's just got up, bless him. That boy can snore.
Boring.
But anyway, look at this down here. What the hell is going on, man? It's like we're powering some kind of, I don't know, like some NASA shit down there. That's just to keep on vaping all day. There's even more here. What the hell? Come on, Sean, now. Gotta have the vape.
Gotta stay alive.
Right, good morning, guys. Day two. Early start. It's about 7:30. And now we're going to head out for a full day exploring. We're going like to as furthest point where we're going away. And then we're going to work back through the places. So we're going to Utah Beach now. And hopefully Pointe Du Hoc, Omaha Beach. As much as we can cram in, really. So, yeah, let's go.
All right, guys, we're on our way. We've just called off at an absolute awesome cafe that Dino found for us. Amazing food.
Got some snacks on the route.
Yeah, amazing sugar donuts. But, yeah, the food was top-notch. And the guy, the French guy that owned it, what a cool chap, wasn't he?
He's an absolute legend.
Yeah.
Real gentleman.
Yeah.
Honestly, luxury.
That's it. So, yeah, real good find, you know, that one. Nice one, man. And Danny even got some takeaway donuts.
And a lolly.
Well, we've just arrived at Utah Beach. I think it's about an hour, just over an hour's drive from the village where we're staying. And this is as furthest away point today, and we're going to visit different points on the way back. Pointe Du Hoc, hopefully Omaha Beach, the memorial, hopefully, and yeah, beautiful weather, beautiful day, really. Let's go. To the entrance to the actual German bunker. Take it with me.
What's it saying, do you know? This German fortification was captured from the enemy on the 6th of June 1944 and used by the 1st Engineer Special Brigade as the headquarters from which to direct beach operations during the landing of the American forces.
This would have been shrapnel from the beach and stuff.
It's entrance to the bunker, obviously we can't go in, but that's a shame, would have liked to go in there. But yeah, all original. Can you imagine what this was seen in here?
Wars could talk.
Yeah, jeez.
So much history and so much. I'm glad we're here seeing it. It's amazing to see it, but it's also sad at the same time thinking just what went down here.
Just what happened, you can't imagine, can you?
No. I mean, this would, I'm assuming these would have all been. This is at the back of the initial bunkers that have been trenches. All different kind of German shelters and structures and things. And cannons blasting, guns firing, MG42 just firing into the beach, destroying everything that coming its way. Absolutely crazy. And here we have a Sherman tank. Let's take a better look at that. Well, that was Utah Beach Museum. Absolutely amazing. Got a few bits from the gift shop. And now we're going to go on to somewhere else, I think. Not sure where yet.
Pointe Du Hoc.
Oh, Pointe Du Hoc. We do know. That's where we're going. But yeah, I must some of that were excellent. Highly recommended. It's almost with the journey now. There we are, guys. Utah Beach. Absolutely awesome. The museum was amazing. I just want to spend a few moments out here. Beach, and a friend asked me if I wouldn't mind getting the memory. Right guys, second museum of the day. We're at Pointe Du Hoc. Just got here, not too far a drive from the last place we visited, Utah Beach. I'm gonna check this one out. Beautiful day. Awesome time to be honest, for the lads, seeing all these historic places. Yeah, loving it. Let's go. Just walking towards the bunkers at the end, but check some of these impact craters everywhere. This must have took a hell of a shelling. Just everywhere. Not sure if the camera's doing them justice, but they're really big. Check this one. What a beautiful day. Just getting so lucky on this trip with the weather. Sunny and peaceful. It wouldn't have been anything like this way back then. The sheer amount of impact craters is crazy.
Thank you. We were dead.
Far away.
Is it on the ceiling? Oh my god, I've got to get out of my head.
On the roof, maybe that's where bunks hung from.
Concrete chuck for the sandbag, just mould it out.
Yeah, yeah.
Put those Hessian marks on it.
Gun position up there.
Gun position? Oh wow. That's pretty cool.
Slap that ass.
Well, that was Pointe Du Hoc. Amazing. Awesome to go inside one of them actual German bunkers. Like you say, you can't go in all of them, but the one you can go in is the best one, I'd say. Yeah, really good that. We're going to move on now and go to possibly Omaha Beach. I think that's where we're going next. Let's go. Okay then, we've just arrived now at the Normandy American Cemetery. So we're going to check this out, pay our respects.
£9
explosives in them, man. Is that Meston's date in 1944? Well, I've actually got US Army Meston date in 1944. That's really cool.
Parce que c'est pour respecter qu'on marche pas sur les traces. C'est seulement quand il y a quelqu'un qui est parti de la famille directe.
Okay then, we've left the American Cemetery now. I drove a short distance over to Omaha Beach. Some of the lads are already on the beach, walking down, exploring it, take it all in. Let's go. Thank you.
some food.
You went well done, mate.
I did.
Again, I mean.
Yeah. So something happens later on, we won't get a chance. And the place might not be
up for. Okay then, guys. The next place we're visiting today is the Bayer War Cemetery. An incredible place. Let's go look around. Just an incredible number of people buried here. At the American cemetery, there was, I think, 9,000. There's about 5,000 here. And almost 4,000 that five, British. I think nearly 500 German. And the other, a few other nationalities. I'll put a little video clip I filmed back there with the actual numbers. If anyone wants to pause the screen and just have a look. Yeah, absolutely. Overwhelming, really. Right, the last night, pizza time, and Josh, you see, is angry. What's happened, Josh?
No onion rings.
They've diddled him out of his onion rings. They've done him.
He didn't say French to him.
You not say let onion ringos? Oh, bless him. Yeah, it's no good to do that.
Pizza's nice, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's all right, man. Let's go.